Hello everyone, I'm Srimanti and I'm currently working as an ML engineer. Recently, I made a video on simple linear regression and the maths behind it. And today I'm going to do the hands-on coding for implementing the simple linear regression from scratch using just Python and some auxiliary libraries like NumPy and Pandas for loading the data set and Matplotlib for plotting the models. If you do not want to implement from scratch, then you can use a standard library like scikit-learn. But I would recommend implementing from scratch because this will clear your fundamentals and you can use the same technique to implement any other future machine learning models. I would advise you to follow along if you haven't done this before. And if you have done this before, then you can pause the video and you can try to implement on your own and then match the answer later. So first things first, what's the data set and what is the problem statement? So as I have said before, like Kaggle is the best data set, is the best source for any kind of data set that you are searching for or any kind of hackathons you want to participate in after you have learned a bit of ML and you want to apply your skills. So it's a good thing to try and find it on Kaggle. So today I also be using a data set from Kaggle only. Yeah, if you can see this is the salary data set from Kaggle. I'll be sharing the link in description. This data set is basically has like two columns. The target variable here is salary, which is dependent on years of experience. So years of experience would be the feature and salary would be the target. So some examples are like 1.1 years of experience has 39,000 salary. 1.3 has 46,000 and like different things. So we need to find a way. We need to find how salary is dependent on years of experience. At first glance, it doesn't look like that it's linear regression, but soon we'll know once we plot the data set. So as I have said, the first step always is to plot the points. Yeah, so now comes the problem statement. So if you can see, this is the problem statement. And here, what it says is that given a salary data set with years of experience and the corresponding salary, you have to use an ML model to predict the new salary of people based on some different years of experience. So, first things first, comes the imported libraries like NumPy and Pandas and Matplotlib for plotting. So, let's do that. SPD. These are the standard nomenclature that we use. Matplotlib.pyplot as PLT. So this is the first thing that we need to do, import all the libraries. So it might seem a little bit intimidating at first if you don't know NumPy and Pandas and Matplotlib, but I'll be covering a video where I'll be teaching the like the basics of these three libraries. That these two libraries are the only ones that you'll need in when you're starting out with ML. So if you have a good grasp on these libraries, like the basic functions, whatever is used most 99% of the time. So I'll be making videos for these, so please stay tuned. Great. Now next comes the getting the data set into a Pandas data frame. So this will help us in analyzing the data set better. So pd.read.csv. So my data set is basically inside a data folder. You can also do that. .csv. Yeah. So you can just download the data set from the Kaggle and then you can simply get the data set out. So I mean, store it in a particular folder where you'll be doing all your projects and all. So the next thing is that what is X? X would be DS. I think the name was years experience. Years experience. Dot values and y would be salary dot values. Great. So if you want to see what does x look like and what does y look like. Great. So we have x and y currently. So now the next step is to plot these points. So this is a very important step whether to know which algorithm to use. So if I am plotting this point, if you see here, you would be able to see that like this is almost like a straight line. You can almost trace the straight line here through these points. So this is This is what the data set looks like, and we can see that the best fit line will be a straight line. This does follow a straight line. It's not a circle, it's not any other kind of oval or anything. It's a straight line. Great. So now next comes normalizing this data set, which is very important. So how do we normalize the data set? Normalizing the data set means getting the mean. So np dot sum. Okay, sorry. One thing, this is still in the form of this is still in the form of like pandas. Mostly we use NumPy array. It will make things much easier. So just make it into an array, np dot array y. Great. So now we have this. We have x and y in the form of NumPy arrays. Now comes the normalizing the data set. So mean x upon len x. Now next comes variance, finding the variance. How do we find the variance? So np dot sum x minus mean. Maybe we can keep the mean as mean x, mean value as mean x, and this would be np dot sum x minus mean value squared upon len x. The standard formula, nothing much. So we have the mean, so we have the variance. Now we have to find the norm. How do we find the norm? X minus mean. X minus, so we have mean value, mean x. We have variance value, variance x. And we have here mean value upon variance value. So now we would have x norm. Great. So now we have x norm. So this is what x norm looks like. So if you do the plot x norm of y, it's also a straight line. So the best fit line is a straight line here. So we know that linear regression is the way to go. Great. Now what comes is that we need to write the class, which is very important right now. So I'm leaving this area blank for writing the hyperparameters. Let's start writing the class. Let's call it simple LR. So first things first, writing the init function. So what do we need here? So if you remember the basics video that I had taught, you would need the learning rate, max number of iterations, and the threshold value. So I'll just go over it in case you haven't watched the video. Learning rate is basically the constant that is used in the loss function. Next thing is the max iteration. We want to run the loss function, the iteration gradient descent for a certain number of steps. So what is the maximum number of steps that we want to run it for? And the third thing is the threshold. Generally, it's 10 to the power of -6. This is mostly in order to find out where to stop for the stopping condition. So whenever the difference in the losses of the two values of the current loss and the previous loss, it becomes less than 10 to the power -6 of the threshold, then we need to stop because the loss is not changing by much, and we have reached a stable point in our linear regression learning. So first thing is the learning rate. Let's just call it LR. Next is the max iteration. And next is the threshold. So I'll just put in some default values. Let's just put this 0.1. Max iteration, I just put it to 2000 maybe. And threshold, I'll just put it 1e minus 6. So self.linear regression would be LR. Self dot max iter would be max iter, and self dot threshold would be threshold. Great. Now comes self dot weight. So if you are aware of the fact, that in the last video that I had talked about, I was talking about the two things which is very important here, the weight and the bias. So the feature that we have here is years of experience, and the and we would associate a weight with this feature, and like AX plus B, Y equal to AX plus B. This is the best fit line. So A would be the weight and B would be the bias, and X here is years of experience. So based on that, we will try to implement our code. So continuing with this, the weight would be some initialized with some random value. So it would be like random dot uniform minus 1 to 1, and the bias would also be initialized with something uniform, something random for minus 1 to 1. So we would need to import random as well. Okay, so now each of these machine learning model functions, they always have a fit function, which is very important. So this fit function is actually very important in the sense that this fit function would return the loss history and help us to understand how the losses are performing actually. And this fit function takes in like X and Y and then sees whether, and then fits the model with respect to X and Y. So this is very important. Now the length of X, let's say N is the length of X, and let's say we want the loss history. So let's initialize this. And we would also need like a previous loss and current loss, because not only do we want to basically fit our function until and unless the iterations total is 2000, we also want to see, we want to break away from the function as soon as the threshold value, as soon as the difference between the current loss and the previous loss becomes less than the threshold value, which is 10 to the power minus 6 here. So for that, we'll need the previous loss. So how do we calculate the loss? It's 1 upon, so this is the loss function that we want to calculate. So it would be 1 upon 2n multiplied with np dot sum. And then, okay, so let's break it down. So errors would be y minus y predicted value of y. So what is predicted value of y? It would be self dot predict x. So we need a predict function here. So for that, we'll be having self comma x. And it would be basically, we know y equal ax plus b, self dot weight multiplied by x plus self dot bias. Y equal ax plus b, and self x a is basically weight and b is the bias. So loss history we have got the predictive function, we have got the errors. So since the loss function, if you remember, it is the this is the loss function, so we would be having errors squared. That is the previous loss. And next thing we want to do is basically go over this self dot max iterations. So what we'll do here is basically we already have calculated the y pred and the errors here, so we'll directly get the gradient function. So y gradient, w weight gradient would be 1 upon n. So if you remember, this is the function and we are just breaking it down. We can write, you can write it directly as well, but it's easier if we break it down. So errors multiplied by x, b gradient, it's called the gradient basically, this part of the function. But the main thing is, it doesn't matter if you whether you write it or not, you can directly update it as well. So as here, like this, self dot learning rate multiplied with w gradient, and self dot bias plus equal to self dot linear learning rate multiplied with bias gradient. Now as soon as we have that, we our work is basically done. So now current loss would be basically calculating this errors and the loss again. So what would it be? 1 upon 2 multiplied with n multiplied with np dot sum errors 2. So the, but the errors have also changed now because the bias and weight and bias have changed. So this is this one, and predicted value of y would be self dot predict x. So if you know that this predict value, which takes in the self dot weight and bias, so this y predicted value will also change, errors will change, and the current loss will also change. So we have the current loss and this. So the this one would be np dot absolute value of current loss minus previous loss, if it that is less than 10 to the power of minus 6, or maybe self dot threshold. Then we'll do break, and we'll finally return loss history. Okay, one thing is that I have to add the loss history dot append Current loss. Yeah, that seems good. One thing also we can do is that if we have your previous loss, we can just do that. Loss history dot append previous loss. Think it looks good. Predict function looks good. Fit function looks good. Check it once. Make it a practice to revise what you're writing, so then you will run into less errors. So, okay. One more thing that I missed was that this one, I'm not updating the previous loss here. So previous loss would be equal to current loss. I think the fit function looks good. Next, okay. So now this one is a bit of a, I mean, it's not really necessary, but it's good to do this so that you have a good idea of how your model looks like. You can compare your model with the best fit line that you have drawn and see whether the best fit line actually fits the model or not. So the best thing to do here is basically self.predict x, and then you will do plot x comma y, the original point, and then x comma y predicted value, our line that we predicted. Great. So now next thing comes is model is basically the initialization of the model, and next thing would be model dot fit x norm comma y, and we would be having the answer as loss history. Great. So now we'll plot the loss history here. So, and next would be plotting the loss history. Great. So now you can see here, even though the max iterations was 2000 here, that is just basically kept in place so that we don't keep on training and training, and we are actually able to see how the losses are performing. So here you can see the maximum number of like iterations it went up to was 160, 161 or something like that. And it did not go up to 2000 because the difference went below the threshold. So we do not need to train anymore, it's stable. So let's see how it looks like now. So model dot plot x norm comma y. Great. So now you can see the best fit line perfectly fits the data set. And I mean it is the best fit line. And we know that our model basically got solved by linear regression. Now, based on any kind of x value you throw at it, our model will be able to give an approximate value of y. Yeah, so I'll be uploading this notebook of mine to my GitHub repository, link in description again. Please check it out. And if you have solved it yourself, then great. Congratulations. You know how to do the simple linear regression from scratch. Okay, great. I hope you enjoyed this video, and thank you. Stay tuned for new videos.